In the last video, we saw three different distributions of Linux: Ubuntu, Kubuntu, and Ubuntu Mate. I mentioned all of these distributions use the same operating system, but a different desktop. I'm sure you've already started putting together that a distribution is just the combination of an operating system and a desktop, and you would be partially right. You're only missing the part that makes it a Linux distribution. Distro is just short for distribution. I will use these words interchangeably throughout the series. To explain the distro a little better, I'm going to oversimplify everything. It might not all be technically correct, but I think explaining things this way will really help beginners and non-technical people understand what makes up a Linux distribution. Hopefully, this will help them choose the right distribution for them. A Linux distribution is made up of three parts: the kernel, the operating system, and the desktop. We all know that computer hardware only understands ones and zeros. So the Linux kernel is the part that talks to the hardware and turns those ones and zeros into computer commands. If we have a kernel to turn our commands into ones and zeros, why do we need an operating system? The operating system keeps track of what programs are running, what's in memory, and allows us humans to interact with it. But it can't talk to the computer hardware directly. That's why it needs the kernel. You can think of the kernel as a translator program, taking the commands from the operating system and changing them into ones and zeros and back. So if we humans can communicate with the operating system directly, why do we need the desktop? Because the operating system only understands text commands, and it's a lot easier for us to use a graphical user interface, also known as GUI, spelled G-U-I. Using the GUI desktop allows us to use our mouse, and we can point and click instead of typing in those commands. Now we know why we need all three parts and why we call it a Linux system, and how we can use different desktops on the same operating system. We can also use the same desktop on a different operating system because we're using the same kernel. Actually, that goes for almost any program. If we can run the program on one version of Linux, as long as we're using the same kernel, we can run it on another version of Linux. The Linux kernel is more important than the same operating system. This video isn't meant to be a history of Linux, but I do feel there are two names that should be mentioned: Linux Torvald, the creator of the Linux kernel, and Richard Stallman from the Free Software Foundation. These two people are most responsible for the GNU Linux operating system. I know most of you have never heard of the GNU Linux operating system, but it's just Linux. We get the Linux part from the Linux kernel, and GNU comes from Richard Stallman's GNU project that created many of the programs and libraries that are still a part of many Linux operating systems. Richard Stallman promoted the idea of having all source code available to everyone. This will allow everyone the opportunity to suggest program changes and bug fixes. The license it's released under allows people to change the code and release it under a different name. The people at Google took the Linux kernel, made some changes, and called it the Android kernel, and created the whole Android operating system. Some people consider all the Android operating systems to be Linux. What we're looking at here is the Linux timeline between 1992 and 2012. I got this from httpfuturist.se. This chart has a lot of dots and lines, each one representing a version of Linux. I'm going to look specifically at the blue line at the top, just under the numbers. We see this version of Linux is called LibreNet. It was started about midway through 1999, and support for this version of Linux stopped in 2005. There's also a line coming in from the left. That's from Debian. Here we see Debian, and that first blue line on top is going to LibreNet. We can't see that in this picture. What I really want to point out is the black line going down. This line leads down to Ubuntu. This tells us that Ubuntu started after Debian, but more importantly, Ubuntu is based on Debian, meaning the people at Ubuntu said, "We like the Debian version of Linux, but we want to add some changes and then release it as Ubuntu." So if the people at Debian stop supporting Debian, the people at Ubuntu would have to come up with something else to keep that version alive. Let's take this one step further. Here we see Linux Mint is based on Ubuntu. The people at Linux Mint took the Ubuntu release, made some changes, and call it their own version. If something happens to Ubuntu or Debian, Mint would have to come up with another plan to continue on. And what we're actually looking at here is the GNU Debian Ubuntu Linux Mint. But most of us just call this Linux Mint. Now that we know what makes up a distro, what is the best distro for you? You should first think about what you want to use your computer for. For example, if you have a really old computer, most versions of Linux won't run on it, but you could try running something like Puppy Linux or Tiny Core Linux. If you're really into gaming, you might want to consider trying SteamOS. If you plan to do a lot of multimedia, you might want to use something like Ubuntu Studio. If you're blind or need other assistive technology, you might want to try Sonar GNU Linux. And there are many more distributions on these same topics out there. These are just some that I'm familiar with. So why don't they put everything onto one distro? And the answer is the distro would be huge, and you would probably not use most of it. So there would be a lot of programs taking up space on your disk and a lot of widgets running in the background that you would never use. The last thing I'm going to show to help you pick out a distro is distrowatch.com. This page has lots of information about Linux distros. In the center column, we see the latest news and updates. And over on the right, a little bit down, we have something called the page hit ranking. It starts up here at number one, we see Mint. And as we go down, we see at 100, we've got D-Linux. The list has a lot of the most popular distributions. And if you want to learn more about them, you can right-click on it. I'm going to right-click on this first one, Mint, and then open a new tab. In here gives us some basic information about this release of Linux. The operating system type is Linux. It's based on Debian and Ubuntu. We saw that earlier. The origin is in Ireland. The architecture is 386 and 8664. This means there's a 32-bit version and a 64-bit version. The desktop, we saw that earlier. We've got Cinnamon, GNOME, KDE, Mate, and XFCE. We saw Mate and KDE in the first video. XFCE is a very lightweight desktop, and GNOME and Cinnamon are not real heavyweight like KDE, but they're kind of middle of the roadish. The categories for this, it's beginners, desktop, and live medium. The live medium means we could run it from a CD and try it out. Desktop means it's for a desktop or laptop computer and not a server or a tablet. And the category beginners, that's us. So we're going to use this version for a couple of reasons. One, it's top on the DistroWatch page. And number two, it's for beginners. In the next video, we're going to create a live CD of Linux Mint.